The U.S. has been flying this spacecraft since 2010, called the X-37B. It was recently loaded into a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket and then blasted into space on a super secret mission right before the new year, with very few details revealed about where it's going, how long it will be up there, and what it'll be doing. And that happened just 2 weeks after China launched its own mysterious spaceplane. The classified nature of these missions has fueled all kinds of speculation about where these planes might be going and whether they could be used as space weapons. So I called a few experts to learn more about what they might actually be up to. Here's what we know. Although the US's X-37B looks a lot like NASA's former space shuttle, it's only about a quarter of the size. It's autonomous, and it doesn't require a crew of humans. And then check this out. When its missions are complete, the X-37B deorbits and lands back on Earth like an airplane.
That's why the X-37 is an amazing capability. It's reusable, it's returnable, it's refurbishable, but it isn't an enormous vehicle that's limited by having to have humans on board.
Because it's uncrewed, the X-37B can stay in space for years. And Boeing, the company that makes it, says that since 2010, it has completed 6 missions, traveled 1.3 billion miles, and deployed for more than 900 days straight. So, what does the X-37B do when it's in space? The official answer is lots and lots of classified experiments. Take a look at this animation. You can see the X-37B flying with its doors open, which enables it to expose materials in space and carry out all kinds of different tests. We do have a little bit of insight into some of the experiments it's done in the past. For example, we know that the X-37B has hosted a power beaming system, technology that could one day enable satellites to send solar power down to Earth. And we also know it carried an Air Force Academy satellite into space before deploying it. The experts I talked to said it could also be used to test materials for satellites or space sensors in various parts of space.
This is national security related, to counter, you know, the Russian-Chinese capabilities that are coming up.
There are, you know, many experiments and many things you would want to do in space that, frankly, we would not want peer competitors to know about, just as they hide things from us.
So let's talk about some of the speculation, like that the X-37B is some kind of space bomber, or that it could be used to test weapons.
There isn't a lot of common sense behind trying to do offensive weapons in space. They sound great in science fiction, but for many practical reasons, they don't make a lot of sense. But no, there's absolutely no evidence that X-37 has been doing anything offensive in space.
This painting, unveiled by the U.S. Space Operations Command, also helped fuel speculation that the X-37B could be used to intercept adversary satellites. That's because amateur space watchers said, hey, that futuristic space vehicle they're depicting, that looks a lot like the X-37B.
It's possible. You can take out satellites, you know, by going close and blinding it with lasers or something like that, you know, it's all sorts of possibilities.
But interfering with a satellite is a little different than actually scooping one out of the sky.
So it actually turns out to be really difficult to do an intercept of an object in space from space, for the very simple reason that when you are in orbit around the Earth, you're traveling at a very, very high speed, a high velocity.
After launching on its 7th mission, the X-37B could be heading deeper into space than ever before. And that's why this recent launch is getting a lot of buzz. Not only did it blast off on a Falcon Heavy, which SpaceX says is capable of going as far as Mars, but the Space Force dropped a few hints in press releases, saying that the vehicle will be operating in new orbital regimes, experimenting with space domain awareness technologies, and investigating radiation effects to NASA materials. That means the spacecraft is probably going beyond low Earth orbit, where it has operated before. And it could potentially even travel 22,000 miles out to geosynchronous orbit.
There are a lot of really interesting orbits that give you new capabilities that cover different parts of the planet. As an example, the Russians have for many, many years used a type of orbit called a Molniya orbit, which is a very high inclination orbit. So it takes them up to very high altitude and then drops down to low altitude. And they can use those orbits to get more time over a certain part of the Earth. It gives you other advantages that the Russians have utilized.
The radiation clue in Space Force's press release could also suggest that the X-37B will be spending time exposing materials in the Van Allen radiation belts, which have been deemed deadly to some types of materials.
You have to take that into account if you're going to establish a satellite constellation higher up.
But of course, these professors say these are just educated guesses, since no one really knows where the X-37B is heading. Against the backdrop of all of this is an intensifying space race between superpowers, and that includes growing competition to develop and build more space planes. The NASA-contracted Sierra Space Dream Chaser could potentially fly this year. And while Russia hasn't made much progress on its space planes in recent decades, China has.
We know that China has been eagerly pursuing space planes for quite some time.
The U.S. says Beijing has been developing two space planes, though details have been kept very secret, and they've been years behind the U.S. in flying them. After one of them launched in December, General Saltzman, the chief of space operations for the U.S. Space Force, said that that plane and the X-37B are some of the most watched objects in orbit right now. And he said it is no coincidence that China is trying to match the U.S.'s timing and capabilities.